Sudan's transitional government and a majority of the armed rebel forces have finally reached a peace agreement. The rebel groups are part of the Sudanese Revolutionary Front, or the SRF. The official signing ceremony was held in South Sudan's capital city, Juba, on August 31st. The SRF is an umbrella organization of rebel groups active in the western region of Darfur and southern states of Blue Nile and South Kordofan, known as the Two Areas. The civil war in Darfur, which began in 2003, is estimated to have taken 300,000 lives and displaced 2.5 million people. In the Two Areas, rebels have been fighting the government since 2011. A majority of the population in Darfur and the Two Areas belongs to non-Arab ethnic minorities. They took to armed rebellion due to the discrimination they faced during the Islamist regime of Omar al-Bashir. Omar al-Bashir was overthrown after a massive people's uprising in 2019, and a few months later the transitional government was sworn in. The latest peace deal seeks to address the concerns of rebel groups. The Sudan People's Liberation Movement North, or the SPLMN, will nominate the governor of Blue Nile and deputy governors of South Kordofan and West Kordofan states. It will get 30% participation in the executive and legislative bodies in the two areas. For 10 years, 40% of the wealth produced in these states will be reserved for the two areas. In Darfur, the agreement makes way for the rehabilitation of the displaced. However, not all rebel groups have signed the agreement. The Sudan Liberation Movement's faction, led by Abdul Wahid El-Nur, has refused to take part in the negotiation until a civilian government is established and peace and stability is restored in the Darfur region. Another faction, led by Abdulaziz Al-Hilu, withdrew from negotiations on August 20th after attacks by a pro-government militia in South Kordofan. The Al-Hilu faction has insisted that the government commit to secularism in the negotiations. A number of challenges remain before peace becomes a concrete possibility in Sudan.